I'd also be curious to know who is this source of intelligence that's feeding warnings about BLM and Antifa to the congressman. That's apparently the only person involved in this thing that we know that's that actually thought that, because the FBI has already said to us they had no information that those groups were involved in any of the activity on January 6th. So I don't think he's put himself in a position of being any less relevant as a witness to the committee.
This reminds me of when Louis Gohmert years ago, Congressman Gohmert, talked about a friend of his at the FBI or a former agent or someone in law enforcement who told him about women, pregnant women coming to have babies in America, and then they would become go back, and then they would come back as terrorists and attack America, and it was a whole plot. Look it up on YouTube. It was an interview. It was an interesting interview I did with him about it. No actual evidence. So, Elliot, if Brooks were to fight a subpoena, how long would that drag out for?
Yeah, I mean, you're talking months, if not years. They just take a long time to enforce. And look, Anderson, I worked both for the Senate Judiciary Committee and then doing this for the Justice Department. They just take a long time. Now, look, Andy's point is exactly correct. This is incredibly relevant information. And if as many Republicans in Congress are making the argument that this is about Capitol safety, if you're saying that you were threatened by BLM protesters, that's relevant to the inquiry that's happening right here. Come in and say it under oath voluntarily to Congress. Now, of course, we have every reason to believe that the Speaker would seek a subpoena if she had to. We have every reason to believe that the Justice Department would enforce one. So he has a hammer over his head if they choose to go down that road. But it'll take a long time once they get into court.